everybody back in the building. What's good? I hope y'all had a good week. You know what I mean? Shout out to the sponsors. You know what I mean? Snow Goons. Make sure you go cop their shirt, hat on their website. Shout out to Creative Juices Music. They got a whole bunch of dope-ass music. You know what I'm saying? They got shirts, merch on their website as well. And shout out to Elite Sound International. Shout out to all my peoples. We got the family, of course. We got DJ Fortnite on the show tonight. You know what I'm saying? It's going down. Appreciate everybody supporting and everything. Getting to popping. I missed last weekend. Yo, last weekend was crazy, yo. Make sure to check out the YouTube, subscribe and all that. Check out that Elder Sensei joint.
Yo.
Yo.
Yo, yo.
Peace.
Peace.
Peace, peace. Can you hear me?
Yeah, can hear you, bro.
All right.
Good to see you, man. It's been a minute.
I know. Kind of sad we got to see each other this way.
Word, you know.
But it's all good.
Word. But yeah, but how's your week going, though, man?
Everything's been good, bro.
No doubt.
Everything's been good. How about you?
Yeah, you know. Touch and go with shit, you know what I mean? But I mean, still blessed compared to what happened, you know what I'm saying, last week to me and shit, but I'm straight.
No doubt.
So, bet. Let's get right into it. We got a lot to talk about. We got a lot of shit to do. So, let's start with your name first, man. Like, how you came up with your name and shit?
I can't say it's a funny story, but my brother gave me that name back in 1985.
Damn.
We were just going through names, and he came up with Fort Knight, which is spelled Fort/Knight, K. It begins with a K, K-N-I-G-T-H, as a knight in shining armor.
No doubt.
So that's how that name came about.
That's what's up, though, man. That's right. And when did you first start DJing?
1985.
Oh, so in that same time frame.
You want to say about, I started DJing about 2 years before that, just messing around at the house, you know.
No doubt.
And then I started doing a few parties locally. Somebody heard about me, which was Apache, and he introduced me to my brother, who was A1 from day one.
And you was in a group too. What was the name of y'all group?
Groups. Peace, Dark Side.
Peace.
1985-86, I was with the group DJ Fortnite and a Unique 3MCs. So shout out to my brothers from U3MCs.
No doubt. That's what's up, man. So what kind of made you work?
What's up?
What was you gonna say?
We did a few shows out in the Hudson Valley, all over the place, bro. Ellenville, Middletown. And we did a major show at Washington Heights Firehouse. That was a big thing, because we had a promoter that was out here doing his thing, and then more or less it was the battle of the crews, which they broke it down when we got there. It was the battle of the crews, so you had a small DJ battle, and then the MCs battled. So you had about five different crews back then at the Washington Heights Firehouse.
That's what's up,
and
man.
Not for nothing, what a lot of people don't know, Stetsasonic performed there.
That's crazy.
So, like I said, it was a monumental moment.
No doubt. What inspired you to be?
What's up?
What inspired you to be a DJ?
Let's get down to that. So listen to mom play all that Motown back in the day, not really knowing what it was. And, you know, I'm thankful now because you know how it is with the generations. Oh, you know, with kids with their parents, you know, oh, what are you listening to and this and that. But now that I realize that was a blessing that I grew up in that era.
Word.
So, you know, it just opens your eyes to a lot of music.
Yeah, of course. That was the beautiful thing about parents having that generation before us, because they're gonna play all that ill shit, and then we're gonna adapt it.
Now, the answer to your question is, I'm sorry, I got off track a little bit. I had went to a roller skating rink party out in Scotchtown. Mm. And there was a DJ, KC was his name. And that's the first time I ever seen Technique turntables, really, even a DJ just getting busy. So that's what inspired me, that fire right there.
No doubt.
So I went out, you know, saved up some money, bought some, you know, belt-driven, direct drives, whatever you want to say, and got me a little cheap mixer, some of my mom's records, and I just practice.
That's what's up. Any DJs that inspired you to be that way? Was it just all crew, or was it somebody outside? Like an artist.
Believe it or not, I still get inspiration from today. Back then, not too much, but my inspiration now, just by seeing what other artists and DJs do, I can get inspired. Like 2 weeks ago, I was just watching a church show. And just the way those people were singing, that's inspiration.
No doubt. I agree with that. I draw all energy from the universe, you know what I'm saying? Especially our family, friends, you know, whatever music we listen to and shit. So, most definitely. See, for those that don't know, this is family, guys. I know this man, I don't know how long now, it's been that long, but, yeah, that's family right there. We talk about everything. We can, we chill, we do all the regular shit. G-U-A-U-T, don't cuff, you know what I mean? The family shit. And everybody else that we hang with, I can go down a whole fucking long ass list and shit, but those that know who we rock with you, man. We appreciate y'all. But,
much respect to all of them.
Me personally, family. I know what you're capable of as a DJ. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm saying, I mean, you showcase some stuff on your page. You a dope-ass DJ. I can't do that shit. So I got to pay homage where it's respect. You know what I'm saying?
I appreciate that, bro.
Word. I always, you know, say watching that UT doing the jiggy-jiggy shit. I'm like, man, I want to learn that shit.
Well, I'm going to tell you. Since you mentioned his name, that's one of my big inspirations, bro.
Word,
one of my big inspirations.
Definitely.
So shout out to DJ NUT.
Word. Make sure y'all check out that DJ NUT.
Exactly.
Yeah, he been doing that. So that's what I'm saying. Like, see, our family, those who we rock with, Dark Side, Decaf, you know what I mean? So many names to mention, but long story short, we all draw from each other's energy. So that's what makes the music beautiful thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Well, definitely. You a legend. I mean, those that don't know you, you a fucking legend. 85, bro. 85, you be rocking. To me, that's a legend. There's time stamps to this shit. Where,
well, thank you.
You know what I mean? Where if you've done your thing from a certain point in time, you still doing your thing, and people know you and what you do, and at the same time, you keeping the hip-hop alive, you're a legend, man. You've been there when it started, and you're still here now. So at the end of the day, my hat's off to you for that shit. You know what I mean?
Thank you, brother.
Most definitely.
You're talking about 30 something. You're talking about 30 plus years.
I'm saying. This is crazy, man. Word. You got a favorite album that you like to spin as a DJ?
How about song?
Yeah, we can do that.
What I grew up on. Crash Crew, Rocking on Your Radio.
Nice. That's what's up. Yes.
That song, when I first heard it, it just stayed in my head to this day. You know what I'm saying? Because that song is so dope.
See, I'm still getting into my older hip hop shit because you know what I mean, when you in school and shit, the weed and this and that, sometimes you just kind of fall off the planet. But for me, that's what happened to me because I was too busy getting high listening to Nas on the fucking thing. And I just completely did not acknowledge any other hip hop existed at that time frame. And then the cannabis album. I could go a whole 5-6 years and just those two albums, Big L. You know what I mean? Nothing else existed. So, you know, when everybody sits there and asks, like, dude, why don't you know this? Why don't you know that? I was stuck on Big L and Nas. Can't get mad at me for it.
Nah. Everybody, listen, Cream, everybody's got their own favorite albums. Everybody's got their own favorite songs. Everybody's got their own favorite groups. You know what I'm saying?
Word. My hip-hop is very particular. I mean, I listen to everybody. I try to support everybody. It's Peace, Poppy, Blaze. That's also the family, man. That's family right there. Poppy Blaze in the round.
Respect.
Way back. Yo, this man knew me when I was like 13 or something. He's doing hip-hop in his room and shit.
Yeah.
He was cutting up shit too, man. Both of y'all, him and DJ UT are my favorite DJ. Flow too. Shout out to Flow, man. Yo, all y'all.
Yes.
I love how y'all cut things up. I blend things. I like how you hold yourself in the hip hop community. You know what I mean?
Appreciate that, bro.
And I feel like the DJs need more respect, man, because I do watch people's shows. I do tune in. I try to be proactive, but at the end of the day, I did notice the DJs don't get the same amount of love as an MC, or the same amount. Well, in my perception, they don't get as much love. And I feel at the end of the day, DJs are the backbone of hip hop. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, they are.
Y'all's the reason why crowds get up and jump. The MCs can rap cool, but without the beat playing in the background, without the DJ cutting it up and adding to performance. You know what I mean? There's no real show. Any nigga can just step off stage and rap acapella. You know what I mean? But to have a really good DJ and a good team, a good MC on the mic, that's what makes hip-hop. You know what I'm saying?
Respect.
Most def. Peace. Respect, yo. So we got niggas be sleeping on upstate. They be sleeping, yo, because when I be having these interviews with niggas, they be like, where you from? You from Brooklyn or something, right? I'm like, nah. I'm like, yo, I'm upstate. They're like, oh, shit. Y'all got hip-hop up there? You know, we got our tractor trailers and farmers and shit, but we got hip-hop. Now let me stop.
Yeah.
But nah, we got so much talent up here, man. Like, we get slept on. But, and you know what I'm saying? I've always said that to you. You've been one of the cats that I felt have been slept on too, because you've done so much in the community. On top of the hip hop.
Yes, and that's just what I was gonna point in that direction. You know, we did quite a few shows together.
Word.
So
word.
There's mad hip hop up here.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
Mad hip hop.
Everybody I see in this room is motherfucking hip hop upstate. Yep. Word. Oh, yeah, for all of them that check this back later and shit, YouTube, man, yo, stop sleeping on upstate niggas, man. We got time too.
Respect.
Word. But, so let's get back into it. So what is more of your, what you want to call it, your forte? Like, do you like to do the jigga-jigga shit, or do you like to blend?
Tell you a funny story. At first, it was the jigga scratch, you know, because that's what DJs were out here doing. Then I got wind of, I'm from the era of pause tapes, which pause tapes came into blending in my eyes. So a little bit of both.
No doubt, no doubt.
And the story is why I'm here practicing. What people don't know, on a daily basis, my blends and little criticism coming from one of my young men. And he told me one day, "Dad, you need to stop blending and put some jigga jigga up in there. Cause I like when you do that." So, you know, I've been practicing my scratching, but cause you gotta keep them, you know, your blade sharp at all times. Word. So, you know, I do a little bit of both. More of the blending.
I definitely agree on that. Me as an MC,
this day and age, it's a whole nother ball game with the blends. And you know, that's my passion.
Word.
To find this beat, to find that acapella, you know, that's my passion.
See, the other thing that people don't know is you actually had a project that's put together. And you had a major hand in it. Like, you know what I'm saying? And that was the anti-time joint that we did.
Yes.
You had a major hand in that. And at the end of the day, it couldn't have happened without you. So,
thank you, Preem.
Keeping it real like that, though. For those that don't know this man right here, is a journalist, a writer, a DJ, a promoter, campaigner, and just overall good dude. So you definitely got it all, bro. Like straight up and down.
Thank you.
But yeah, I mean, you're doing your thing, though. I mean, like I said, hopefully we can showcase some stuff tonight. It's just, you know what I mean? Because talk is cheap and shit at the end of the day. I'd rather just show people what you're able to do, and then, you know what I mean? We can go from there.
Yeah. A little something.
But before we get to that, because I want to count. Let's get more detail for stuff. So for those that don't know, you also was in hip hop shows.
I didn't hear you.
That's it. Doing our hip hop shows.
Yes.
Now, what was your initial feeling on it? Like, you feel like it was worth it because the satisfactory of knowing that you get it, or was it you enjoyed it because overall you brought people together and you were able to get what you was planning on doing, like way back type shit?
I just wanted to, when I met you, and like you said, I've been promoting since 85, because really that's what you had to do out there. You know what I'm saying? Not just be a DJ to these parties. You also had to get out there, do the legwork to promote. We're talking about the era of drawing up
America Online. Flyers on a piece of paper. Niggas, they had the smartphones and shit. You had to walk your ass around and slap your stickers on.
We didn't have no social media, no nothing. So you're talking about way back when, and you know, doing that footwork.
Word.
So, you know, putting the flyers up on the telephone poles, in stores, just hanging them up, you know, anywhere they can go.
Word. That shit's great. I was born in that time frame. I really appreciate it. I love hip hop. That shit's in my blood. But like,
Yeah.
Be able to witness it from happening, you know what I mean? Transitioning was it like freestyle house music into hip hop, into so on and so forth. Like, to be there and actually witness it, it's gotta be utterly amazing. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, yes, sir.
I bet I will say this much though, for y'all DJs, I do know a lot of DJs do still carry the crates, but I'm pretty sure it's way easier for y'all now to not have to drag around three crates worth of fucking records and vinyl shit.
You said 30 crates, right?
Oh, and see, there you go. You had something like that around there. You had a whole motherfucking team dragging crates in this shit.
But back to the question. I think it was more satisfactory that I was able to do it / with you.
Word.
Because you introduced me to a lot of artists.
I do not, man. You did it all.
Yeah. So.
Oh, DJ, you take pace. We was just talking about you, brother. You know what I mean? Much love and respect, man. And once again, check out that Bumpy Knuckles by you, too.
But it was more or less the satisfactory of being able to do it. Let me see. About a second or third time of, coming back out, not doing nothing, coming back out, you know, just low key, and then back out, you know, as a promoter. So, with the times, of course.
No doubt.
So I still want to see if I had it in me. And I thank you for you know, being half of that team.
I was just, you know what I mean? Like, me personally, man, like friends or family. So any way I can help somebody achieve their goal, their success, whatever, that makes me happy. That completes me as a person, that completes me as whatever you want to call it. So you came to me with your ideas and whatever else, and I seen that you really was invested in it. I was like, yo, fuck it. I'll go all out. Let's do it. You know what I'm saying? If I got to slap somebody or whatever, let me know what we doing. You know what I mean? Fortnite, like, let me know, because I just...
And I respect you for that, bro. I really do.
I mean, because like I said before, man, like everybody that we see in the room thus far, so many names, all of them have done unique things for our community that a lot of people might not respect and might not appreciate. But I tell every single person in this room, at least once a week if I can, like, y'all appreciate it. That's the truth. You know what I'm saying? Outside the music shit, you got to check in with family. You got to make sure everybody's straight. We just got to work more together, because it's just, you know, it's us against them type shit.
Yeah. Exactly.
So, but I'm just grateful to be around all y'all. Because as far as I can tell, y'all are older than me. So, at the end of the day, I appreciate y'all letting me kick it around y'all.
Yeah.
Because when I stepped into this circle with all y'all first, I'm just like, I don't know what to get myself into, man. I'm just a young kid not knowing nothing. Got Fortnite, put me on the shit, and you team Poppy, Blaze, Slow. Everybody was schooling me with the knowledge. So to be younger than somebody and to appreciate what y'all be doing, it's fucking awesome, man. Y'all kept me into hip-hop. If it wasn't for y'all, man, I would have thrown this shit in a while ago. I just don't got the capacity for shit no more. You know what I'm saying?
That's real, though, most bro. Most I appreciate death,
it. You already know what time it is. Hey, you know what? That's the problem with what's going on in the world. People can't.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, people just can't be honest with themselves. They'd rather lie to themselves by being deceitful, by pretending to be something that's not. Just be real, man. If something's dope, then, you know what I mean? Tell the artist.
Support it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Support it.
So.
It's not that hard. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. That's another part of the game, man. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't support your own family, your own friends, and your people, man. Ain't nobody going to fuck with you.
Like, nah, not at all, bro.
Because there is such thing as references out here. You know what I'm saying? Because you go to a bigger net artist or this person, that person, they're like, well, who are you, bro? Wait, don't nobody fuck with you. It's like, that shit looks silly. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I cop my friend's music. I support business. You know, our businesses and shit. A lot of people won't do that shit. I don't care. Like, NUT, for instance, this man will try to hold me down. Like, yo, I'm buying two. I'm doing this. I'm buying one. I'm doing what I can. Like, if you came out with a Merc line, I'm going to go cop it. Like, I do what I can within my budget.
Yeah, yeah. But that's all of us.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it's all about. You know what I'm saying? It's all about support, man. Like, fuck that funny shit. Like, word, but your blends are crazy though, Mike. So, just to talk a little bit about that, because you are working on a project right now, release shit. So why don't you talk a little bit about that?
It's in the works right now. Honestly, I had to step back away from all that because I was, it was just some things going on in the family, so. I had to step back from that, but now, like I said, I'm just getting my artillery together, Preen. It's coming.
No doubt. So
it's coming.
So the project itself is going to be a mixture of blends, correct?
What's that?
the project you're putting together is a mixture of blends and stuff, right?
Yeah.
So why don't you talk a little bit about that? So what are your blends going to be based around?
They're mainly going to be based around what I'm trying to do is get a different sound. Not all, how can I put it? Not all the instrumentals are going to be what you normally hear. Not all the acapellas are going to be what you normally hear. So that's why it's going to take a while. Listen, I got some artillery, bro. Seriously. And for anybody that doesn't know, you can go down my page and check out my blends at Ellsworth. So, and I appreciate all the love in the past. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, probably sometime at the end of the year. That should be done.
And it's coming out way before that. Trust, yo. We go ahead. You know how the fuck I am, nigga. I'm not gonna sit here and be like, end of the year. Nah, fuck that. We talking like a couple months, at least. You know what I'm saying? You know how I am, yo.
Yeah.
But I've heard pieces of it, and that shit needs to drop in summer. You want my opinion? I should say.
Well, we're gonna see what we can do for the people.
Word. I mean,
definitely gonna see what we can do for the people.
Bullshit.
You're not the only one that has gotten at me before. I had other few people like, yo, when you dropping that? So, you know, I'm working on it. Yep, I'm working on it. And I can definitely tell you the title of it.
Yes, I know your whole life and stuff. So it's like, I agree with the whole family type scenarios and shit. Like, it can delay you, especially when you're like a single parent or a single parent. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're dealing with everyday life. So I'm pretty sure a lot of us can relate to that shit. But at the end of the day, it's just going to build you up to come back strong.
Exactly.
So from what I heard, shit is fucking fire. So, and you know me, yo, I'm an ass when it comes to critique because I'm not going to hold my tongue. I'm not going to be like, yeah, that shit is fire, and then toss the shit out the window. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to sit there and be right there like, yo, we should change this. We should change that.
Yeah.
Word. So, you know what time it is.
That's what's up.
That's what that's what's up. That's what another reason why I appreciate you, bro. Cause, yo, you dealt with my assholeness, my being a jackass or whatever you want to call it, because at the end of the day, I always got something stupid to say. I appreciate you dealing with me. Word. But we've been through a lot. We did a lot. And I'm hoping upstate can kind of get the shot of the dirt. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because, you know what I'm saying? We're not too far from the city. I mean, I can understand we're like miles and miles away. Like, you know what I mean? Light years away, some shit, but they might as well be our fucking cousins. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Well, we need our motherfuckers.
Prima, I don't know if you see that, but Poppy Blaze said we need a reunion.
Well, yeah, I seen that shit earlier. I didn't want to cut you off and shit while we were discussing shit.
Yeah, it's all good.
Yeah, we definitely need to do some shit, man. I'm telling you. Gotta have four of the best DJs, man. Like, I'm doing a fucking live session and shit, bringing all these fucking rappers and shit. Yeah. Unknown niggas into the platform and shit. Fucking summit, yo.
That would be dope, bro.
Yeah, I'm saying. I mean, me personally, I'm not really into the whole crowd shit anymore. Like, you know what I mean, for those that know me, like, I'm a homebody. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I think y'all could throw together some shit that was, you know what I mean? Like, it could turn into a Rocky Bells type shit. It just continues every year. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we all definitely know we on that shit.
And not for anybody you want to shout out. When you asked me about the group thing, I was also part of another group back in the late 90s, early 2000s, maybe mid 2000s, and I was down with the Pyromaniacs. So also shout out to them. Not one but two groups.
Oh yeah, y'all. Word, no doubt. Word, no doubt. Yeah. I'm stuck though, man. Like, yeah, kind of like I want to get back into that shit. Like, the whole shit. It's cool doing shit on solo tips. To feed off each other's energies and everybody, you know what I mean? Having a good time and shit. That's what hip hop is. That's what hip hop. You know what I'm saying? That's what keeps me alive and shit.
True.
Oh, this shit's out of crazy. You got a SoundCloud page, or is it just your Facebook and Instagram?
Facebook and Instagram. I don't have a SoundCloud page. I'm trying to get something done on Mixcloud.
The anti-bully shit. Where was that again? Yes. That was on Bandcamp, or was that off of audio?
The anti-bully. I'm pretty sure the anti-bully was on SoundCloud.
All right, so pretty much everybody that wants to tune in to some of the shit done previous. DJ Fortnite, anti-bully album or EP or whatever we call it. It's got a bunch of various artists on it, and it had to deal with going against bullying, jackasses. You know what I mean? Just overall.
Yeah, the everyday bullying thing. So, I'm thankful that we put that project out.
Word. I mean, you got...
That was a dope project.
You had such a great mixture on that shit, man. That shit was hot.
Yeah.
Straight up. Yeah, I'm telling you, man. Before we retire, man, I'm trying to see all y'all. Like, you know what I mean? I'm not worried about me. I'm worried about y'all. I'm not worried about me. Me, y'all don't give a fuck about whatever. Because y'all already know where I stand with y'all. But I definitely want to see all y'all do y'all said. Like I said once again, y'all don't get the appreciation out of it. This ain't going to be one of them shows, though, where we throwing up trophies and shit. But I'm just giving y'all flowers. You know what I mean? While I can.
Peace, Lord Supreme. Peace.
Yeah, so moving on to sex. Well, what you be doing in your spare time? Rocking the turntable and shit.
What's that?
What you be doing in your spare time and shit? Like
spare time and shit. Like
my spare time, I really, you know, as far musically, I just you know, work on my blends. Like I said, I'm working on this project right now, so it's gonna take me a little bit longer because I'm trying to find stuff that you don't really hear in blends.
Now, so, for those DJs that have had those one button, whatever the fuck it is, that does everything automatically. What's your thoughts on that shit?
My thoughts on that, seriously, a DJ should be able to use anything that's put in front of him. Right. Turntables, controllers, CDJs, freaking double cassette, a turntable, and a CDJ. It doesn't matter. A real DJ should be able to use and put what's in front of him.
I like that answer.
So I don't really get
into that. That's how I feel about MCs.
Yeah. I don't really get into that, you know, that so-called quarrel of, you know, turntables against controllers, you know, because here's the thing. If you're always on turntables and the club has CDJs, what are you going to do? Run back home and get your turntables? You know what I'm saying? So it doesn't really matter. Like I said, again, whatever you put in front of a DJ, that's a real DJ.
That's what I say. That's the same thing for me with, like, MCs. Like, that's why when I have MCs on the show, I want to challenge them. You know what I mean? I feel like if you're too comfortable, then it's like you can't achieve past the peak and shit. Like, I mean, a lot of us have been doing this so long now that it's like an obvious thing, but there's a lot of components missing, like, from having season. Such as freestyling, yeah. Such as freestyling. Like, you got the little tracks with the gavel, the acapella battle, five on speed, but that's predictive. You know what I'm saying? Because they built that months in advance, but it's like you have to be able to have every piece of artillery. Nah, man. Because especially me, I'm an asshole. Like, if I know you a rapper. And you out here on Instagram talking about you the best nigga ever, and I see you in person, I'm going to step to you like, yo, let me hear some bars, do some off-the-head shit. I'm not going to be like, this is what we do, because it's the same as the DJ. Like you said, put anything in front of y'all going to rock. So if you an MC, you should be able to rock a cappella, or at least attempt to. You know what? I don't care. You suck, and you still try. I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that too, man. We can work this time. But like, don't get discouraged, or don't be it. Oh, give me $200,000 on freestyle. Like, nah, nigga. I'm sorry, that don't fit. I'm sorry. But yeah, like that's what I'm saying. Like that's thing is to be able to do everything or try to do everything or try to, you know what I mean? Turntable, push button. Me personally, with my opinion on that, like his push button shit, I feel like it is cheap. I mean, yeah, it might be popping, yeah, it might be more convenient, but at the end of the day, the problem with that is you're not putting in demand time to learn to be a DJ. Like, I'm not saying all DJs, I'm saying there is those DJs that they're like, yo, I'm a DJ, I press buttons. It's like, that's like an MC being like, yo, I'm the best MC ever, but don't know who Rakim is.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you have to be able to do every aspect of it. Not just push the button. Like, learn how to scratch. I feel like they be cheating because y'all over here actually using the mixer, the crossfader, and the jigga shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
You're putting in the actual labor. These niggas over here pressing the button, everything's already done. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, yeah.
That's like me stepping in a battle with another nigga, and they got a written that they had months back, and I'm just freestyling off the head. Like, you know what I mean? You cheat. There's no other way to look at it. You cheat. So. The only advice I gotta say for that, opinion wise, like, yo, if you're gonna be a DJ, at least participate. You know what I mean? Do it the right way.
Yeah.
Anybody can type in those Mario cheat codes. I mean. But anyways.
But there is, but I'm gonna tell you, with me personally, there is a big difference between a controller and turntables, because the controller is compact. So turntables here, mixer here, turntable here, are two turntables and a mixer, however DJs use it. But the controller is set up, you have less space between, you know what I'm saying? You have less space to use. So might be a disadvantage, but once you start practicing, you know, you'll get it.
Yo.
You'll get it.
Yo. Once again, shout out to my brother at UT. This man, I'm surprised this nigga wasn't Debo by now. Lifting the fucking, what is that, caskets or whatever y'all call with the turntables in it. You know, we've seen NUT carrying them shits all the way to the fucking station. I'm like, this dude should be Debo by now. Like, I respect y'all for that. Shit, I'm trying to wait, bro. I might just start lifting some fucking crates filled with vinyls and all types of shit. You know what I mean, turn the home into a fucking hood gym. Shit. But you know what I'm saying? But yeah, nah, definitely, man. DJs are the greatest. I love a good hook. With, like, cuts in it.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, all that shit. Like, I love it. Let me ask you this question, though. Have you ever bought a vinyl or a CD and it just sucked? Like, you couldn't listen to it again afterwards?
Not really. Hmm. Not really.
Because I know y'all DJ. That guy, like, probably Blaze put me out to this movie. I was like 13, 14, about a record pool and shit like that. Where you guys can get like bulk vinyls or like a mixture of vinyls, like a purchase or something like that. So, like when you used to get those, I don't know if you got those type of things. Like, I'm still learning about all this shit. But
was that the record pools?
Yeah. Like, they give you a bulk vinyl or something like that, right?
Yeah, they give you bulk vinyl, and I don't know how that works, because I was never in an actual, how can I put this, vinyl record pool. See what I'm saying? I was never in, because it was easier for me to just, you know, either go to Newburgh, DMU, or go down to the city, Rock and Soul, and some other places to pick vinyl. And that's where you can actually take your time, go pick your records, and listen to them. They allowed that there in those stores. So, you know, you got your money's worth. And on top of that, you already heard what was on the radio. You know what I'm saying? So, oh, I got to go cop that. I got to go cop this. You know what I'm saying?
I think the one thing that was dope about that shit with the whole vinyl shit, like, was the fact that the vinyl came with singles, edited, cursed version, and the instrumental. So,
oh, bro, they came with a lot of edited, clean, dirty, instrumental, a cappella. You know what I'm saying? It came with everything.
And I think that shit dope. Because I think back then, the only time to get those singles like that was the vinyl, I believe, right?
Yes.
And the cassette to the company. They did the singles here and there, but the vinyl had everything on it. Like, word. That shit, that was a great time. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, it was.
Out.
I am in digital record pools, so you know that's where I get most of my music from.
Oh, no doubt. There are a specific vinyl you like to spin, like where you just at the crib.
I don't even have vinyl anymore, bro.
Oh yeah, because you got the other shit. Let's kick it back. If you had your turntables still, would there be a favorite vinyl that you want to play? Like regularly.
Off the top, I can't really. Probably.
He's like, come on, Supreme. I've heard so many vinyls.
Off the top, really, nothing comes to mind. Because I've adapted to, like I said, the digital record pools, so really don't. But as far, let me see, as far as vinyl, probably J. Rooter Damager, the first album.
Yeah,
because that was so tough.
Mm-hmm. Which album?
The first one.
East for the East or some shit like that.
Yes. When the East is in the house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What else was on there? Come Clean.
All the classics she was on.
Yes, yeah. All the classics.
Yeah, well, yeah, I can feel you on that. When I seen that Kung Fu video he did way back, I forgot the title to it. I'm pretty sure you already said it. But the shit was fire.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that was the first time I seen hip hop and Kung Fu in like the same, whatever time frame and shit. So that's definitely what's up. Yeah, I don't know. I probably would play a Wu-Tang shit, yo. If I could sit in the crib and use the vinyl all day and shit, I'll probably listen to Wu-Tang shit, yo. Not gonna lie.
I would probably just listen to everything, you know, no real favorites, just what it is with me. It's got to come from here. You know what I'm saying? It's got to come from here. So... If it hits me, it hits me. Yeah, so it's just more than, I mean, that is my favorite, but.
See, yeah, I would have to go with Nas. Nas too. Because, yeah, Nas is huge in my life. I can listen to his song all day. So, like, if I have a vinyl one, if I play it at its highest quality and shit. Like, you know how they got the memes and shit where they got the big ass speakers and they're like, yo, what would be the first record you play us and shit?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yo, I would probably have to throw on the message. Nas the message. If I could play a joint worldwide like that.
Yeah.
If not that, then fucking represent. Those are always our fucking deck, you know what I'm saying? Most deaf, yo.
Yeah, that's what's up.
Outside the fam, you got any favorite DJs that you are inspired by?
I didn't hear you.
Oh, I'm not saying outside the family.
Outside the family?
Yeah.
There's a few. That dude, I don't know his name, but I think he was the original DJ for the Beastie Boys. Mike was his name. Rock Raider.
Word.
Grandmaster Flash. Jazzy J. You're talking about from the early days of hip hop. So, and my man Cool Mike Ski. So, just to name a few.
Well, I know it sounds, I don't know what the word is, cliche, or whatever you want to call it, but definitely Premier. Premier P Rock. Like,
yes, and Premier too.
Definitely, yo. It's crazy. All the shit that these DJs do, man.
Yeah. And that DJ's name from the Beastie Boys, Mixmaster Mike, he's just ridiculous.
No doubt. Yeah. You do any other elements of the hip hop and shit? Like Beatty, like E-Boy?
No, not really. Just the, you know, the promoter and the DJ. It's mainly my lane.
No doubt. You rap though, didn't you? At like one point.
I had one rap back in the day.
You said one.
Damn. And that's the time I was with the Pyromaniacs. I had written some stuff, and that was mainly it. I mean, it wasn't nothing, but it was some, for me personally, it was something.
No doubt, no doubt. So, well, you got some shit you want to showcase, you know what I mean? Okay, you know, words is cheap, but
we're going to try a little something.
Yeah, you got some fire. Let's hear some fire, man. You know what I mean? Friday night. People trying to get it popping and shit. Shout out to everybody still. Appreciate y'all. I promise we ain't gonna play no trap.
It's gonna be all trap. Can you hear that? Mm-hmm. Or is it too loud?
left, son. Maintain it. You know? Good, bro. Anything proper still, bro. Come on, man. What's the matter with you, man? Ain't nothing. Just want us to be here. Get your boots knocked.
What y'all think?
Yo, bro. The fucking records you was just playing had me in the motherfucking zone, man. I needed that motherfucking shit. I had a fucking horrible asthma. So, yeah.
Bro, when you told me to do a little set, that's what I picked out.
Yo, yeah.
I got it together as soon as you told me, so.
I'm going to have you do some of my hooks, man. I need some of that. Some of that shit, you know what I'm saying? Word, man. Yo, man, the records you playing, Loop Home, yo, Dos Effects, Chubb Rock, of course, you had to throw
Lord
the
Lord Supreme, thank you, bro. Lord Supreme, thank you. It's my brother right there. Respect.
Word. That shit, yo, that shit was lit, man. That's why I'm anticipating.
Hey, listen, bro. Listen, I'm going to tell you, I wish we can go for longer, but, you know, there's rules and regulations over here.
Yeah, you know, you know how Instagram is, man. They're trying to lock niggas up and shit now. Like, oh, yeah, he's playing such song. That's what's tough about it, because I was fucking shit here. Shit, you was playing, man. Fucking fire, yo. I was just listening to some of those records, too. That's the funny part about that. You call my watching that shit today. You know what I mean? Word. Yeah, that's why you family, bro. You know what type of motherfucking music I like, nigga. I'm like, yo, wait. Niggas just seriously just pick a whole playlist out just to fucking get me all hyped up and shit.
Yep.
Well, it fucking work, nigga.
Thank you, word. Bro. Word. Thank you.
That shit's good. Yeah, let me ask you this question. Back to the elements of hip hop. If you was able to do one other thing other than being a DJ, which would you pick? MCing, breaking, graffiti?
Probably graffiti, because I like art.
Mm. Yeah.
I love art, bro.
Word. I kind of wish I could spin out my head, but yeah, the graffiti, let me get a hold of that shit, yo. I fucking tag up people's houses. I'll tag them motherfuckers inside and shit. Yo, yeah. I was trying to learn how to draw shit like that. It ain't work out, bro. Let me be able to graffiti. Yeah. That's why one of my favorite movies is B Street. Nah, man. I said it before. But
exactly.
Like,
yep.
Like, man, you seen the murals. You seen the murals. The graffiti they was doing. That shit was wild.
Yeah.
To be able to have your fucking.
You got
to
get up with you got to get up with me one of these times so we can take. I can take you down to the Bronx, bro. They got those got that go old school shows with all the, you know. The founding fathers.
No doubt.
Yeah, we'll definitely have a good time.
See, what I thought you was gonna say though, the way you started that off, I thought you was gonna say, "Yo, I gotta take you to go bomb some trains." I'm like, "We could try, nigga. It's gonna look like doodle art and shit all over the train." Like, man, who the fuck is that whack ass shit? We was trying.
Yeah.
Word, man. Yeah, I mean. I would love to.
You got me in the zone now, bro. You heard?
What happened?
You got me in the zone now.
Yo, you got me in the zone, man. Like, shit. Now I'm anticipating that project even more, man. Like, I'm going to have to have you on some hooks and shit. You know what I'm saying, too, man? This is going to be fire. This is what I'm talking about, man. The DJ is the fucking backbone to this shit. Yo, I had a fucking shitty day, bro. Horrible day, nigga. I wanted to knock niggas out with the whole nine and shit, but then you playing that shit?
You told me this morning. Yeah, you told me this morning.
Oh, motherfucking day.
No radio?
Bro, yo, for all those tune in and listening later on, yo, let me know who's able to go a whole day without. Like, because I think that's like I can't function. Like, I think that's why I was in a horrible mood. I couldn't play my Nas. I couldn't play my R&B shit. You know what I mean? I'm just saying, like, oh, man, fuck everybody. All these packages are going in the package.
Which one? Hey, which one's got a radio in it?
Yo, shit, word. Yeah, we going to save that one. No doubt, no doubt. Yeah, we definitely got to do some future shows. Man, I got to have these DJs and shit and by Yelps and whatnot.
Most def, bro. We'll get up. We'll get something rolling, bro.
Word out. We'll call it.
Definitely get something rolling.
Rock the Bills remix. That's your dope. That's your yeah. Dope. So mom.
Rock the mic remake.
Of course. So if you had an opportunity to choose an MC that you could, I mean, DJ you could go without listening to for a whole week. Who do you think you would choose?
One more time.
If you had a DJ, like you can go a whole year without listening to him, like at all. Like they're this straight horrible. You have any that comes to mind?
No, I don't.
No doubt. I don't know. DJ Khaled. You know I had to say some dumb shit. I just feel though I gotta speak on it, bro. I know you humble as fuck, bro, and I know NBT humble. Everybody humble. Me, I'm just a loud ass Latino. I don't know. So at the end of the day, I look at it like this. DJ Khaled, nah. I'll go a whole year without listening. Like when I heard Nas dropping an album with him, I was getting a little iffy. Shit, I'm like, nah, shit, I'm like, shit. But I'm a Nas fan, yeah, so let me give it a try.
True.
But yeah, nah, I can't. Nope. What you think about this Instagram Live shit? Because I know you was looking into it, right? You wanted to do some live blunts and shit like that.
Oh, we could put something together, bro. Definitely put something together.
I would like to have you run inside like once a week. You know what I'm saying? At least, like, once a week, just have you rocking the turntable, showcasing what you're able to do. Just playing some fucking dope ass music. I mean, but what I just heard, I already know your fucking arsenal is pretty much my arsenal. So, I mean, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We need that, man. We need that. All the DJs having, all our upstate DJs having their own show at least once a week. Take over the whole motherfucking Instagram shit. DJ Fortnite Friday. NUT Saturday. Poppy Gray Sunday. Flow Wednesday. You know what I'm saying? Like
Bum rush the show.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think we need that for like a whole week of this hip hop and shit. Just take over everything. Like I said, yo, we get hated on. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We do get hated on. I still remember Alpha Faction, man. When we went out there and ain't nobody know nothing about us and shit. We're like upstate niggas. And then Alpha Faction just broke the whole motherfucking building down to the ground. All of a sudden, everybody was like, oh, yeah, these upstate niggas ain't nothing to play.
No, they're not. So, shout out to Alpha Faction. Respect.
We don't get the love we deserve, man. We put in the motherfucking same work, too. Shit.
Yeah, but see, you got to understand one thing. We're in a smaller, how can I put it? We're in a smaller place for hip-hop compared to the city. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, we're on length away, though.
No, that's tuned in. You know, there is a lot of talent out here.
So, like, if there was to say some shit like Prime Bush, like Pennsylvania, PA, or some shit like way out and shit, it would be a different story. But like, we in arms reach away from the city.
Arms reach, yes, we are.
So, if you think about it, we all should be building, like, not like, oh, well, there's some upstate. It should be like, yo, there's some New York. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We all New York. So at the end of the day, New York. I mean, like I said, though, I know Pine Bush got the aliens and shit. And, you know, you got other further upstate niggas that got cows and all types of shit going on out there. But like Middletown, right by the motherfucking city. Like, hop train type shit or whatever the fuck, right there. Like, so I feel like we need to be building our city brethren, our city to be breaking bread with us, man.
No doubt, no doubt.
Most definitely. Most definitely. Yeah, man. But anybody got any questions for Fortnite?
Man, there's so much on the screen. I ain't even to able to you know.
Yeah, I might try it all.
Yeah.
Over the place and shit. I know it's a bunch of people dipping in now, but it's all good. What are you giving? Shout outs, bro.
I think I've shouted everybody out. I seen Ruin Rebel in here. Peace, Rebel. Dark Side, peace. Everybody that checked in, Lord Supreme, peace. And whoever else is up in here that I missed. So.
No doubt. Anybody outside of who's in here, though, like anybody that want a shameless plug and shit?
Yeah. My man out in Sweden, Wes, what's good, bro? I hope you tuned in. That's family right there.
No doubt. And you gonna be doing any future charity joints, like anytime soon, before the summer?
As of now, I can't be say 100% no, and I can't say 100% yes, but it's up in the air right now.
I got an idea. I'm putting it live online. Because
that's another thing that goes along with hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not all about the music.
I'm going to put an idea out there. I know I should have because it's live. No other than probably going to be all on that. You know what I'm gonna say. But I was thinking, for the summer, we should maybe do a charity or some shit. We can like hand out drinks or something, like water, shit like that. People can like, you know what I mean? They don't got shit. So this way, nobody goes behind. Nobody, you know what I mean? I noticed there is a lot more homeless more recently than there has been.
Yes, there is. Yep. There is.
Like, I still give my money to somebody on the street. I still try to buy them food and stuff. But, like, I think it's summer. You don't even know. It might be motherfucking 100 degrees. Look at the snow and look at how everything's been happening. So,
yeah.
I look at, like, yo, maybe we do some summer shit. You know what I mean? Hand out some waters or something.
Yeah. We could definitely put something together, bro. Yeah, we could definitely put something together. Because, as you know, there's a whole team.
Exactly. Good shout out to everybody there. Shout out everybody that's part of the team, too.
Helping hands, helping the community, for those that don't know.
Word. Like, I mean, because we ain't out there like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people wouldn't understand. We ain't out there like, oh, look at us. We're doing a charity event. Everybody come shake our hands, pat our backs. It's like, nah, it's like, we just try to help out the community. We've been doing this for years now. Like, Mother Ruckus, when I first met Mother Ruckus.
A good 7 years now.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? We've been doing this for a minute, bro. You know, like, I feel like that's what more artists, more people in general, we met motherfucking humanity. Like,
exactly.
Ain't that motherfucker serious? If niggas can fucking buy a good pair of Jordans, why the fuck can't you give somebody some money? Like, you know what I'm saying? Come on, man. The fuck about respect, it? I got the motherfucker buying my shoes falling out my shit. And I still give my last set to somebody. Yeah, he ain't got no money.
Yeah.
That's
real.
That's just the outlook. Like, you know what I mean?
We definitely gonna talk later, bro. We'll definitely put something together.
Yeah, I just want to put that idea out there. I like
that idea too. So,
make it into like a water park type shit. Squirt people with a fucking super soaker or some shit. Like, you get a car wash going. Nah, you'll be good. So, that's just for those that didn't know. Some stuff that you've been doing. I mean, like I said, I'm not trying to put myself out there. I want people to acknowledge you and what you've done. like for the community, like for hip hop, and what you still do to all these artists. I don't think niggas understand how much of a supporter you are to hip hop, to artists. Like, this man buys the merchandise. This man likes, pushes, shares all his people's posts and his artists, favorite artist posts. Like, he spends his money and invests it into the artists that we are cool with or artists that we listen to. So I got to give you respect for that. With that being said.
And go into shows.
Yeah, and this man would travel all the way out of his way just to go support a show. Like, that's a real motherfucking support right there, if you ask me. That's great, bro.
That's great.
I just want to show you my appreciation. I seen how you be pushing people and stuff. And, you know what I mean? Like, that needs to be acknowledged. Any type of fan, any type of support, it don't matter who it's from, it don't matter where it's from. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, most deaf. But you got anything else you want to add? I think we should wrap it up. Kind of set the bomb, drop the bomb with the fucking mixing and blending and shit. Like, I don't know if we could top that now, because that shit just fucking blew my mind, the records you were playing, because I was just playing those records. That's why I was like, damn, look, this nigga like hijacked my playlist. Like, that's how I was feeling, yo. I was like, what the fuck? I'm like, yo, who randomly just out of nowhere just plays fucking group home? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's, it's one of those things. It's like, that's why.
Yo, peep game. While you're at work, I call the boys when they get home. Yo, let me know what your father listening to, what your father likes.
Yo, I wouldn't be surprised, yo. That group home joy is fucking fire, bro. Like, this shit.
Thank you, bro.
Oof. But, like, yeah, you pick up. Yeah. We're gonna finish this down before the end of the year. Before. Yeah, you mark my words, nigga, before the end of the year.
Most deaf, bro.
No doubt, but
as soon as we get out of here, I'm going right back to work.
Bet. I know, I can see it, yo. It's like I feel bad too, because I want you to rock all fucking night, but I already know if you do that, there goes that fucking motherfucker.
Yeah,
that bitch.
We gonna plan something though, bro. Yo, we gonna plan something together, so I can rock live. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Now, no doubt, so why don't you tell everybody your handle and shit, so we know how to reach you.
My handle Facebook is Todd Price. Instagram is Ellsworth. So you know, either our Facebook, Instagram, Ellsworth at Ellsworth on Instagram, and just regular Todd Price on Facebook. That's where you can find me at.
No doubt, no doubt. You have any other shots?
That project 813 is coming this year, before the end of this year.
Before the end of the year.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, you better add that in, man. I'm telling you. I ain't retracting my statement. It's gonna be before the end of the year.
All right, bro.
But no doubt, got any other shout out.
I definitely want to shout out everybody that tuned in tonight.
No doubt.
Just mad respect for that. So
no doubt, yo. Definitely shout out to your boys, man. That's a great kids.
Well, thank you. Likewise.
Word.
And I wish yours was, I wish yours would stop growing, bro.
You know what I'm saying? I wish all these kids would stop growing, man. Just living the moment and shit. I feel like shit is going too damn fast. Like, it's hard for me to keep up.
Yeah.
No doubt. But yeah, so yeah, look forward for the project and shit. For those that are going to check you out, like I said, EJ Fortnite got an album, Anti-Bullying. I'm not sure where it is. You might have to type the shit on Google and shit for people to tune into that, because I don't remember that.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's Bandcamp or it's fucking Audio Mac. I'm typing DJ Fortnite, how his name is on the flyers and shit. And then Anti-Bully. It'll be pulled up. It's like a whole EP.
Anti-Bully Project.
So definitely check that shit out. And, yo, I appreciate you, bro, man. Like, yo, you already know. You're going to have more, man. Trust me, man. You're going to be involved. I'm going to have to kick your ass a little bit and make you a co-host here and there. You know what I mean? get the show flowing and shit. I'm going to have you and Jason One just hopping in and out, man. Like, you know,
okay, that's what's up.
Make this shit happen, bro.
Yeah, we definitely going to speak on that, though, bro. So.
No doubt.
All right, then.
I'm going to talk to you in a few, bro.
All right, then.
All right, yo.
Peace.
Peace. Yeah, but that's the family. DJ Fortnite, man. You had a good night. All them joints he was playing, man, they had me want to get up and motherfucking jam. You know what I'm saying? Shit. RuPaul, like Nas. Oof. Anyways, yeah, make sure to follow him and shit. Ellsworth and whatnot. He's got an upcoming project. He's already got a project out and shit for the launch. Check it out and whatnot. We got Sofa King on the show tomorrow. That's Creative Juices Music and shit, like the family and whatnot. And just wanted to give a shout out once again to the sponsors, of course, Snow Wounds and shit. Lee Sound International and of course Creative Juices Music. You know what I mean? So be sure to tune in for tomorrow and shit for another show, man. I hope you have a good night. Peace.